We'd like to show you the general skills mat. The first skill any student needs to learn is to make the robot drive straight and to start and stop when it is supposed to. Using the ruler in the center, the teacher can provide a unit of measure such as 30 centimeters and ask the student to drive forward, stop, drive forward, stop, and back up, and have them work on that with precision. The second skill is turning. Down on the right side of the screen, we have a compass. A teacher would have the student put the robot on the center and turn a designated number of degrees and have them practice until they learn to control the motors accurately in such a way they consistently turn the robot to an accurate number of degrees. At this point, the student has two major skills down. They can drive forward and backward, and they can make the robot turn accurately. Skill number three is using basic sensors and understanding how they work. There are color and there are black and white light sensors. We'll start with the black and white light sensor. A teacher would ask the student to move the light sensor over each of these blocks and measure the density. Of course, the black ones are all the same. The various blocks will have different densities. Then they want to do the same thing with the color blocks and with the black and white sensor. Then replace the black and white sensor with the color sensor and measure the colors of the various blocks on this board and record them so they can use this information later. Once they've done that, have them drive forward until they hit a black line, or have them drive to the second or third line. Have them drive forward until they hit a certain density that they've measured with their light sensor, or a particular color with their light sensor. At this point, the teacher could also simply put a wood block on the field or some other heavy object, put the touch sensor on the robot, and have them drive forward until the touch sensor hits the device and backs up or turns or whatever you'd like them to do. You can also put the ultrasonic sensor on the robot and have them drive to a proximity of the block. Again, just provide opportunities to see how each of the sensors work. The next major skill is line following. There are several programs out there for many systems on how to do that. Start by having your students load the program, build the robot with the recommended sensors, and be able to drive straight on the line even if the robot veers right or left. Once they can do that, move down the line and work on getting the robot to make turns. This is a very complicated part, but it is essential for almost any robotics challenge or competition. Students should work on that until the robot can successfully navigate this entire path. Once your student has mastered these, they can combine them and do even more. Over the first couple of weeks, your students will have mastered all the core skills. The next step is to combine them. A couple of examples are drive to the sixth black box, turn 90 degrees, drive down until you hit the black line, turn right, follow the line back to the junction, turn left, go to the seventh block or the purple block. The last part of this mat would be to have them move to these objects. They'll discuss how they can find the green, yellow, or brown block. Have them move an object from the base here to that area and back. You can also then combine three-dimensional objects by putting wood blocks or other objects on there. Have them build a device that will have them lift something up and put it on and back away. Just remember, using this mat, you can teach virtually every concept you need to master for desktop robotics. The challenges and creativity are limitless, so have fun!